lot of disgusting things going on in the industry, and these people are far from perfect. So, you know, I think that we need to understand that if we are idolizing someone, it's taken us away from our beliefs, it's taken us away from our values. That has become an idol to us. Let's be honest, okay? Let's be honest. A lot of us are on social media, and we might go into the wee hours of the night just looking at different people's profiles and different people's lifestyles and what they're wearing, you know, looking at them from head to toe, trying to figure out how did they get like that? How did they look like that? How did they get the man they got? How did they get the car they got? How did they get the success that they have? And it's okay to admire people. But again, when we take it so deeply to heart where we want to become extremely like them, to the degree that it alters our values, it alters our beliefs, we begin to just, you know, shun to the back burner what we've ever been taught and start to mimic their lifestyle, mimic the things that they do, mimic the things that they say, then that's when it becomes a problem. So, y'all. This is a Bible study, in case you have not known. So I'm going to be going straight to scripture on this because it ain't about me. I'm here to just share the truth. But you guys feel free to comment, okay? I couldn't let my daughters watch the BET show. It's too much. It's too much. It's not modest anymore. We don't have good perceptions of female images. You know, you got to step onto the red carpet with your complete body showing. They're not even wearing full dresses anymore. This is just like butt cheeks everywhere, boobs out, nipples, no bras. And I'm not hating. I got to feed it. I got to tell the truth. But it's not modest anymore. And so let's listen to what the Bible says about idolatry. We're going to start at 1 John 5 and 21. Let's see. 1 John 5 and 21. And hopefully my light did not dim. Y'all, can y'all still see me? Hey. 1 John 5, 21. Let's see. It says here, little children, keep yourselves from idols. Keep yourselves from idols. And, you know, it's not just people that we idolize. It's things that we idolize. I don't want to get too much into the stones and things like that, and just like the different gods that people serve today. That's not the discussion that I'm having tonight, but more so on idolizing people, idolizing images that we see regularly on social media. But we're being addressed here in 1 John 5 as little children. Why? Because we're that precious to God. We're that dear to God that he calls us his children. So it says, little children, keep yourselves from idols. Okay. Next scripture is going to be from 1 Corinthians 10. Y'all praying for me? 1 Corinthians 10, verse 12 through 14. Let's see. It says, wherefore, let him that thinketh he standeth, if you think you stand, take heed, unless you fall. There has no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that you may be able to bear it. Wherefore, my beloved, flee from idolatry. Flee from idolatry. This is not my word. This is the word of God. This is a word from your Father, who considers you to be his child, his precious child. It says, flee from idolatry. And then in Psalms chapter 16, verse 4, let's see. 16, verse 4, it gives a warning, and it says, their sorrows. This is the one that got me, y'all. This is the scripture that got me. Because a lot of people say, you know, well, you know, maybe I am idolizing a little bit. Maybe, you know, but I just really strongly admire them, you know. And we start to question, like a child with their parent, why can't I have that toy? Why can't I have that cookie? We start to question God. And he says here, and is given a warning in Psalms chapter 16, verse 4, it says, their sorrows shall be multiplied that hasten after another God. I don't want my sorrows to be multiplied. I don't want my life going any more haywire than what I've already experienced. Can I get a heart to that? Like, we have gone through it just with the pandemic alone. I don't know about y'all, but I do not want my life getting worse. But he plants a warning there in Psalm 16, verse 4, that that the sorrows of those who follow after idolatry will be multiplied. If you're following after another god, if you're following after another person and idolizing them, and we're going to get into that, what idolization really truly is. Because it's okay to admire someone. It's okay to admire maybe, you know, what they say they stand for and admire their families, you know. But again, like, y'all, social media is deceitful. You'll be following somebody's account and then you just get warped into it. And before you know it, you're starting to change the way you dress. You're starting to change the way you act. And you are becoming who you are following. What they say, birds of a feather flock together, or you become who you follow, right? I mean, how many of you guys have had like best friends growing up in school, and y'all might have been two different people when you first started off, but the more you kicked it with each other, y'all just started dressing alike, y'all started acting alike, talking alike, and doing the same things. It's the same thing when we idolize someone, we become like that person, like that individual, believe it or not. So Psalm 16 and 4 warns us that when we idolize things or people, that our sorrows will be multiplied. What about Colossians 3 and 5? Let's see what it has to say. Y'all can comment. What's up? I see y'all. Thank you for joining in. We are talking about idolatry. Just kind of piggybacking on what I saw in the BET Awards. I'm not happy about it. I'm not happy about it because we're losing true images of beauty. Our daughters probably won't even grow up to see much of it on TV anymore, much of it on social media anymore, unless some of us stand up and become examples, true examples before them, okay? So, but it's not it what people are given on social media, what people are given at these award shows, what they're displaying, and not just what they're displaying, but their lifestyles. Like, I'm listening to some of the music and it's very deceiving. You might be rocking to that beat, it might sound good, but y'all listen to the lyrics. It's insane. It's insane what a lot of these artists are encouraging people to do now. We'll get into that in a second. But Colossians 3 verse 5 says, mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscences, and covetousness, which is idolatry. Okay, let's talk about the covetousness. You know, you're envying what somebody else has. And how often do we do that, y'all? Real talk. Be honest. When you're on social media, you get warped in because, one, it's entertaining, but then what do we do, too? We start comparing our lives, right? Fashion is being impressed by entertainers or celebrities. We want to dress like them. We want to mimic the lifestyle that they have, right? So God is giving a warning here, and he's saying to mortify therefore your members. He said, covetousness is idolatry. It's a form of idolatry. So, and then also Revelations chapter 9, verse 20. Let's go there right quick. How many of you guys read your Bible on a daily? Anyone? Anybody read your Bible on a daily? You can heart, you can wave. No Bible readers? Okay. How many of you guys believe in God, at least? Not mandatory. I'm not forcing y'all to say you believe in God, but how many of you guys believe in God? All right, because a lot of people believed in God when that pandemic hit. You know, let me get on my knees. Let me pray. Lord God, please help me. Higher power, please help. And I'm saying, let's not wait till another pandemic to get on our knees and pray. Let's seek God now, you know, while he may be found. That's what the Bible says. Seek him while he may be found. All right. Praise God for that. Revelations 9, verse 20. What does it say? It says here, And the rest of the men which were not killed by their plagues, yet repentant not of their works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Y'all, I talked about this in my last live, that to follow after people who are not in Christ is like following the blind. You're walking after people that are walking blindly. You're walking after people that are walking dead. They have no true life. They have no true life. And let me just pause for a second, because I'm not just speaking to speak. I've been listening to the testimonies of secular artists, entertainers, who are either still in the industry or who have made their way out of the industry. And they're telling it like it is. And for those who listen, they might gain something from it. But a lot of them are saying, I'm not gonna quote anybody's words, but that it's not the life they truly want. Cardi B spoke about it on Twitter. Her words were caught before she actually deleted her post, but she basically said, this is not the life that I wanna live. You know, and she goes on to talk about how her music was actually entertaining devils or bringing devils. She said the same demons that she had conquered a while ago were returning in her life. So we are following, we are idolizing these people in the world, thinking that their life is a life of success and they've got it all, and they got the man and they got the car and they got the family and they got the money. But to follow these individuals is like following a dead man walking. It's the blind leading the blind. How many of you guys, if your favorite celebrity would tell you, follow me to hell because there's gold there, would you follow? I stay on the clearance rack, that's right. Let's talk about that. Like, what is a clear indication that we are idolizing people is when we go broke. We go broke trying to look and trying to be like these people, right? I stay on the clearance rack too. For sure. But a clear indication that we are idolizing individuals is where we got to have the cleanest fit like every week, the red bottoms and you know, the lip injections, the face distortions, and we got to have the pumped up lips, and we got to have the false lashes. I'm talking about the individuals done like weekly, and we go broke. And for some people, maybe not broke, but wasting money when there are people in the community who need money, but we're wasting it because we're trying to look like the people that we say we're not idolizing, but we are. Okay, so I noted this, and you guys tell me if you agree. When we idolize things and people and we turn our full attention to it or to them, we are actually turning away from God. And I'll probably get to a scripture where it describes idolization as worshiping that person, worshiping that thing. Well, the issue with that is our worship is meant for one and one alone, and he is Jesus, he is God, he is our Savior. Our worship, our attention, our full attention is really truly meant for him. He wants to have an intimate relationship with us. That's why he referred to us as little children. I love the fact that I can call my God Father, and he calls me his daughter, he calls me his child, you know. But when we idolize things and we idolize people, we actually turn our attention on them and away from God, and that's where we begin to see chaos slowly creep into our lives. That's when we begin to experience things that we didn't know we were welcoming. Okay, we'll get to that in a second. Let me ask you guys, and maybe you're not dealing with idolatry. Maybe you're not, okay? But I'm still having this talk about it because idolatry can be a very sly thing. I literally have had to unfollow certain accounts that I was following because I realized it was starting to influence me, the way that I thought, The way that I acted, the way that I dressed. And this is in time past. I'm in a different space in my life today. I must pause for a second and read comments. Lemony starts again. And every day I have to. Yes, your inside is what makes you beautiful. It ain't the clothes. It ain't the clothes, you know. But the really disturbing thing is a lot of people who are being idolized today are living the most dark lives. They're not going to always admit to it. But y'all, just go on. Just when the truth hits the fan, believe it. If these celebrities are speaking out to you about what they're dealing with in the industry, how they're tied to the industry, how they're puppets for the industry, how they don't want to live those lives, believe them, okay? But we're still following after these same people who are trying to red flag us like, this is not it, you know? And they're warning about their songs that they're putting out are welcoming demonic presences. And I'm telling you, like, this world is not going to get better. It's going to get darker. And the reason why I'm sharing what I'm sharing month to month is because if we don't have Christ, y'all, we have nothing. If we don't stand for something, we fall for everything. Okay? So I'm encouraging you guys to grab hold of the truth if you don't know the truth already. So I'm out the loop, but I just looked up the outfits, and it looks like the women are taking their clothes off and the men are putting their clothes on. Facts. Well, let's all become sex symbols. We're going to get to that in a second, because I'm going to tell you what comes with that. I've been married 21 years, and I'm going to tell you that right there will not, it won't help a wife. It won't make somebody a wife. Being completely revealing themselves. It ain't it. It's not it, you know, but we have to rise up, and we have to become examples for the young women that are coming up under us, you know. And if you have daughters in the house and it's something that's playing on TV that goes against what you're teaching her, turn that junk off. Hey, if TV is so disturbing today, does anybody feel that? Thank you. Television is very disturbing today. Like, it's hard to, if you're not grounded in your home, if you're not teaching your children the word of God, if you're not standing on the word of God, it's very easy to be manipulated and deceived by everything that we're surrounded by. Television, social media, music, it's none of it, most of it is not clean anymore. And like I said, to idolize these things is like, following after the blind, following after the dead. I'm not trying to follow after no dead person that's going to the ground to rot. Anyhow, let's think about this. What does idolizing do for anyone? Or ask the question, what does it turn me into? Like I said earlier, and I had to admit that in times past, I was following certain accounts, and I it may have started off where I was just admiring somebody's family, admiring their children. And you know the cold part about this? You have a lot of celebrities that are initially claiming to love God, claiming to love Christ, and they'll be on that hype for just like a short moment, and then all of a sudden, you see them doing everything under the sun. Everything under the sun. And it don't add up. I'm sorry. If you have Christ, if you have God in your life, there's certain things you are not going to do. Don't tell me you're a child of God if you got your butt all out on social media. It don't add up. Not clean, not uplifting. Facts. TV is for conditioning and manipulation. Facts. And I've had to pull back. I'm not trying to be deceived by this world. And this Bible gives us, what do they call it? The book of instruction before leaving earth. You know, what would we be if we didn't have this? We would be so deceived. We would be in total darkness. A lot of us would be deep in depression and just flat on our face. So I got to give thanks to God for his word. So idolizing, what does it do for people? What does it even turn us into? Everybody wants to look like Nicki Minaj. Everybody wants to look like Cardi B. Man, it's crazy. When I look at a lot of accounts and profiles on social media now, it's like everybody is turning into the same sex symbol. The same sex symbol. I'm happy to see you too. I don't want to be a sex symbol. I want to be a God symbol. I want to be a true example, because the sad thing about it is when we idolize those things, we also welcome the things that come with that life. So let's get into that. Idolizing, what has it done for you? Or what has it turned you into? Has it altered your character? Are you now someone that you didn't imagine that you would be? One thing that idolizing can do to a person is it can lead a person into depression because they can't measure up to the image of the one that they are idolizing. Back in the day, everybody wanted to look like Beyonce. They wanted the big hips, the tiny waist, the boobs, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people began to develop low self-esteem because they couldn't measure up. But we're not all created the same, you know? I had to pull back. I had to just discover what made me beautiful, love myself for who I am, the body that I'm in, you know? And I definitely don't need to showcase it on social media to everyone, period, period. But idolatry can lead people into depression because they can't measure up to the image of the one that they're idolizing. No matter how hard young women are trying to measure up to these celebrities, first of all, they're paying millions of dollars to look the way they are looking. They're getting plenty of injections to look like they're looking. Who did I just see on BT Awards? Y'all, drop the name right now if you know who's in my mind right now, whose body just looked completely unreal. Drop the name. I idolized money. Didn't matter how it came, but it wasn't until I found my why that I found my fortunes. Yes. Yes. Yep. Yep. A lot of injections. They got the money to do all that, but our young girls are losing it. They're either what's the disorder where girls are, well, not just girls, but guys too. The disorder where people starve themselves. They're trying to find alternate ways to develop these bodies like the celebrities who are paying millions of dollars to have their work done. But y'all, Lil' Kim's body on BET Awards looked completely unreal. Am I saying it right? Yeah. Completely unreal. And not just her. We see it all throughout on the red carpet. Yes. All throughout on the red carpet, these hips that are like, what? Back in the day, it was only grandmas walking around with hips like that. I'm just saying, old grandmas who, you know, cooking in the kitchen, the greens and the mac and cheese and stuff, you would see them wobbling around with their, you know, let me stop. But what is going on? What is going on where everybody wants to have like this little pencil size waist and these huge, unreal looking hips, right? They're trying to conform to the image of this world. It's real talk, you know? I like to think of it like, in all honesty, when I see the bodies that are displayed now, they look like Barbies. Y'all remember the Barbies back in the day? Had little bitty waist and the little thighs would pop out and you could pull off the legs. Anybody ever pulled off legs from your Barbies? but those legs look detachable. Am I lying? Their legs look detachable. Their bodies look detachable because they are fake, you know? And we have our young girls out here starving themselves to try to look like this. Even turn into pimps to pay for their services to look like these women and then being abused by their pimps. And the men that claim to love them ain't yet put a ring on it. Listen, idolatry can lead a person into depression because they can't measure up. Idolatry can also lead people to do and practice lawlessness. Idolatry, you know, maybe it's an actor, or maybe it's a lot of people, you know, people look up to so many different individuals in the entertainment world, but, you know, even coveting somebody's things can make a person want to go out and steal. And they may have never imagined that they would do such a thing. But y'all, the world is lawless. Why do people do the things that they do today? Because they are idolizing individuals. They are idolizing the world. They got to have it in a quickie. And so people turn and they go and they run up in the malls. It's one of the reasons why a lot of our cities don't have the malls that they should have. They've taken malls away from certain cities because of lawless people who are going in and thieving all the time, taking material merchandise out of these stores and it don't belong to them. So, and that's because they're idolizing the things of the world. How many of you guys remember when the pandemic hit? And I know it was kind of like a rioting too. It was an act of just like rioting, but you saw a lot of people run up in Target and Walmart and they just went in and crashed the whole place, ran up in the stores and took as much as they could and ran out. It was crazy. This week blew my mind. I saw this doctor from Beverly Hills that performs the surgeries. Yes, insane. And they, you know what? They don't care if you die during the surgery process. They don't care. Give them their money. Give them their money. Who was it? Kanye's mom died, I think, either during or after a surgical process like that, where she was having work done. I mean, I know it's not being put out on the news how many people go under these surgeries and never come out. It's unfortunate. But idolatry can also lead people to be lustful and promiscuous. I want to get on this one right quick. If who you're idolizing is lustful and promiscuous, guarantee you, you're going to become that. You're going to be like that too. I was looking at Chloe on the BET Awards. Very unfortunate. Young, beautiful girl. And I feel like her and her sister were really manipulated by the industry and made into these sex symbols. You know, they started off with innocent songs and innocent images, but now just everything is off. Everything, lap dances on the BET Awards, lap dances, you know, young women who should be capped, who should be maybe with a ring on their finger, you know, and probably truly really desire that. But guess what? They're not going to see that because they're out here giving lap dances to people and pulling off their clothes to people they don't even know. Idolatry can lead people to become lustful and promiscuous. That's why a lot of the women that we see on social media today, rarely do we see young women who are actually displaying modesty anymore, right? Am I right or am I right? Rarely do we see young women displaying modesty anymore. And it's sad, it's unfortunate. But how many of you guys are gonna stand up and become those examples for these young women? They need us. They need us to be true examples to them of what modesty is. You certainly can't become a wife or a good mother or the woman that you need to be by idolizing the women that are being promoted today. You can't. Let's get on that real quick though. And y'all, I'm gonna get through this message. I don't know how long I'm in, right? I just have a few more notes. But idolatry will not make a wife a good wife, a mother a good mother, or a woman who wants to be a wife a wife, because they're being blinded by the images that they see on social media and on TV. And people begin to wonder why. If you want to know if you're idolizing anyone or anything, look at your family life, look at your marriage, look at your relationships. What have they turned into? Because a clear sign of idolatry happening, idolatry is attached to so many things. The moment that you idolize a person, you idolize what they have too. Okay, so you have pornography going on. You have just wicked lifestyles happening, and you know people begin to wonder why their families are becoming broken, why their marriages are being broken down and disconnected, and why the relationships are going bad, because we want to be like the people that we see on TV and on social media. And think that that's going to give us a good turnaround. We want to be like the people that we see and hear on social media and on television and think that's going to give us a good turnaround. Let's talk about that for a minute, because how many celebrities, how many entertainers are you actually seeing that are in solid marriages? I went there. How many entertainers, how many celebrities do you see with solid marriages? Most to none. Most to none. But can we talk about this whole boss hype where the women say you can be overly sexy and business is very confusing for you girls, for young girls. Absolutely. And that's what I'm getting at right now. Like, the return, the ROI is not what these people are claiming it will bring. It is bringing depression. It is bringing suicidal thoughts. It is bringing brokenness, confusion, right? You said it, confusing. Young ladies are being confused. And rather than being led to become material for good wives, they're being led to become more like porn stars, right? More like porn stars. And they're thinking, okay, this is going to get me that man. Wow. This is going to get me that man. No beautiful young lady, if you're dressing like the world, you're not going to have that good, faithful, because don't no man want nobody out there dressing like a facts. That's not wifey material. That's not wifey material at all. But, you know, we idolize these people, these things, and then we wonder why we can't keep a man. We wonder why we can't keep a job, right? We wonder why our family lives are broken. We wonder why our marriage is displaced. We're following after these people, trying to be like them, trying to talk like them. Housewives and stuff like that taught a whole lot of women how to be ratchet. Housewives on television taught a whole lot of women how to be ratchet, and now they cannot keep a man. They can't keep a job. They don't know how to even prepare themselves to be wives. And it's unfortunate because deep inside, a lot of these young women want to truly settle down and be married. But it's not going to happen if we're following after the world, period. I love the comments. You guys have been, thank you. Thank you. The ROI, it don't add up. But the world is telling us it will, right? Listen, you're going to be out of a job. You're going to be without a family. You're going to be without a husband trying to follow after these symbols of beauty, these symbols of success. And the world is putting them on because they are their puppets. They're putting them on. And half these people, if they say a lot of these people are worth millions and things like that, but how many of them are actually have that? You know, I mean, if they were to walk away from the industry, what would they have? They would have nothing because the industry would keep it because it doesn't belong to them. It's borrowed. It's borrowed. Those houses are borrowed. The jewelry is borrowed. The clothes are borrowed. Ask me how I know. I done worked with enough celebrities. You know, they want to look good for the red carpet. They got, and people think that because I'm a celebrity makeup artist or anybody that they see, oh, they must be getting really paid. No, celebrities don't pay nothing. Nothing. So, you know, I've experienced a lot just being around that industry, but a lot of that stuff is borrowed. It's borrowed. The image is borrowed. You know, if they were to leave the industry, or if you were to see them on the street, who are they? A lot of these artists and entertainers are not even who they portray to be on the screen or in their music. And I've been hearing a lot of those testimonies, you know, coming from artists like the music is not even them. They're trying to be a good father at home. They're trying to be a good person at home, but they're being forced by the industry to release music that is deceiving us, deceiving our people, you know. And I'm going to go somewhere with this, but I don't want to throw any race under the bus. But, you know, a lot of people are living check to check because they are trying to live up to that image. Can't invest in a house, can't invest in the things that will really be a legacy or an asset because they're too busy trying to, you know, have the small things. You know, I used to work for attorneys, and if you ever want to know who's balling, it's the people that look like bums. A lot of times, is the people that look like they don't have nothing, because the people that really got money, they're not entirely flamboyant with it. They don't want you to know how much they got, you know? But back to idolatry. Idolatry, and we might start off admiring someone or something, but if it turns you away from living righteous or worshiping God, now you're there worshiping that person. You can't keep off social media. You can't keep off that person's profile. You're now wanting to be like them. You're now wanting to go have that job done just to look like them, you know, and you're beginning to worship things. You're beginning to worship people. And you might think it's not worship, but how much time are we spending looking at... I've been in the company of people who can't stop looking at certain people's profiles. Get off of social media. Go do something productive with your life. Go to bed. Get a nap so you can have some sleep for work in the morning, you know? But we spend far too much of our time looking into the lives of these people, and then we start to question ourselves, well, am I beautiful enough, you know? Yeah, but if it turns you away from living righteous, if it turns you away from worshiping God, then it's an idol, period, you know? And I asked earlier, like, how many of us are Bible readers? How many of us are in the Word daily? And it doesn't have to mean like you're in the Word for hours at a time. Honestly, I start off with a devotional in the morning, and it might be anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes. And that sets me straight for the morning. Now I might have to feed on some more Word later in the day, because honestly, the Word should be just like our eating habits: breakfast, lunch, dinner. You know what I'm saying? We need it that much so that we're not prone to being deceived by this world and prone to being deceived by the enemy. And God willing, God help me, I'm going to be opening up to something supernatural, because it fuels my passion for sharing these messages. I have seen too much to be silent. And I want not only for myself to continue to be free, but I want to help other people walk free. And y'all know freedom is in Christ, for sure, for sure. And his presence is liberty, and his presence is peace, and his presence is fullness of joy. And the world is lacking a lot of that. So let's make sure that we are turning our attention to the one that can really give us a good ROI, and that's Jesus. So last few verses, what is the resolve? If people are caught in idolatry, how do they get out, right? In the Bible, it constantly speaks about turning back to God. He encourages his children. We are his children. Come back to me. Return back to me. Return back to your first love. Turn away from those things, right? So let's go to Ezekiel 37:23. And I'm almost done because I'm not going to take up too much more of y'all time. Ezekiel 37:23. It says, neither shall they defile themselves anymore with their idols, nor with their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions, but I will save them out of all their dwelling places wherein they have sinned, and will cleanse them. So shall they be my people, and I will be their God. So it starts with turning away from those things. If any of this message has pricked you, or any of the Bible has ever pricked you about that lifestyle that you thought was the lifestyle, God is speaking, turn away from that. That's what he encourages us as his children to do. Hold on, wait a minute. Don't look at that. Don't listen to that. Don't go that way. And he's warning us out of love. He's such a loving father. He's saying, don't listen to that. Don't follow that. Don't do that. Because he knows we're sinful. We're wretched. We think we know it all as humans, but we need to rely on our Heavenly Father who sees and knows all beyond what we can even see, y'all. Because, and I'm going to get into this at another time, about the physical world versus the spiritual world. We are in both. Period. But we think we know it all. We're in a physical world and a spiritual world, and we need to become more awakened to understand what's around us, what's truly around us, what's making us feel a certain way. You know, what's making us feel depressed? What's actually tearing apart our families? What's tearing apart our relationships? What's causing chaos in our lives? You know, we need to be aware of the physical and the spiritual world. So, but it starts with turning to God, turning away from the things of the world. We are in the world, but we're not of the world. So we have to be separate. We can't be like the world and be like God at the same time. It is impossible.